Hello students, hope you all are doing well. So today I will conduct a lecture for BCom first year semester 2 and my subject is business management. As we are going through with our unit 3 and in that today we will focus on control. Earlier we have seen the topics like planning, decision making, centralization, decentralization, okay, and how it is important in the process of management. Means every management has to perform the functions like planning, organizing, directing, staffing and controlling. These are the basic functions, and in that basic functions every, what do you say, topic which is mentioned in our syllabus, okay. Obviously, our syllabus is framed as per the need of the subject, as per the need of the particular. Here we are discussing business management. So, in business management, what is the extract of it? How to manage the business? Okay, management. How a man with available resources, how an entrepreneur with n number of resources, how he is managing, how he is planning, directing, controlling, and appointing various personalities, various persons at different places, at different designations, considering the requirement of the business. So, management means how to manage the business, how to manage the enterprise, and right from the beginning up to the continuous running of the business. So, the main target is to achieve its planned goal, to achieve its pre-decided goals. Okay, and these pre-decided goals are somehow different and separate from each management point of view. But ultimate aim is what? To earn maximum profit. And for earning that main aim, to achieve its primary goal, these kind of functions are taking place. Now, when we talk about the specific in this particular unit, okay, as you know, we are covering delegation of authority. Here we are earlier seen that the delegation of authority, okay, first of all, it is very important. Work must be delegated, work must be transferred to each and every employee considering his or her educational qualification, considering employee's X performance, from where they are coming from, what is their background and what kind of work they have performed in the earlier organization. Everything is decided and accordingly the work is delegated and distributed to them. Then we have seen centralization and decentralization. Again, and now here we are on the topic of controlling or coordination and controlling. Coordination we have seen in last presentation, and today we will go through with controlling. So, controlling is what exactly? For example, a department, okay, a production department has given the orders from the top management, from the production manager, for example, and production manager have given the instructions to perform a specific task, to perform a job work, or to perform any activity which is in record or which is in reference with the manufacturer. Now again, the production manager, he is well known about that particular activity, so he is giving instructions, he is passing on the information, and again, what is controlling? Finally, to judge that actual performance, means to judge, to analyze, to verify, okay, whatever has been told exactly, had it been done according to the according to the given instructions. So this is what is checking with the actual performance. Okay, now as we are continuously discussing, the management, every management sets its goals. Okay, now to achieve these goals, okay, these things like coordination, okay, controlling comes last. Now why last? Because finally at the end stage only the things are analyzed or the things are checked. Okay, controlling means finally what? Okay, for example, the teacher, she has given you the assignment. Now it is up to students to solve those assignments. Once the assignments has been distributed, okay, once the assignment has been passed on to the students, now it is up to the teacher to check, to evaluate those assignments. Now after evaluating, it means what? First she is giving the lectures, or she is explaining that particular topic. On that particular topic the assignment has been given, and then the assignments means the performance of the students has been judged in the form of assignments by the teacher. Otherwise there should not be any control. Now in this sense, controlling is in what sense? Because to controlling the study, to controlling their educational qualities, that is what is here in the case of assignment. But when we talk in the terms of management, then what has to be done? So it has a specific, once the job is delegated distributed, then whether the delegated job, distributed job has been performed correctly by the employees or not, that is what exactly here in the reference to the management is controlling. So controlling consists of verifying whether everything occurs in conformities with the plans adopted. Okay, whatever has been planned, everything is taking place as per the adopted plan, as per the set plans or instructions issued and principles established, right? So controlling ensures that there is effective and efficient utilization of organizational resources so as to achieve the planned goals. Again, just now whatever I have explained, that is given here in this meaning. So the definition we will see. Now what Breach says, according to Breach, controlling is a systematic exercise which is called as a process of checking actual performance against the standard or plans with a view to ensure adequate progress, and also recording such experiences as is gained as a contribution to possible future needs. Correct? The concept which I have told you just now, it is a systematic exercise. What is that? Controlling is a systematic exercise. It is a kind of system where, or which is called as a process of checking. Okay, it is checking actual performance against the standard or plans with a view. Now something has been said by the management, okay, different policies are framed by the management. Now whether the things are taking place as per the set policies, as per the framed policies, that is what is controlling. So recording such experience as is gained as a contribution to a possible future needs. Correct? So I hope the meaning and concept is clear. Again, we will see the second definition. According to Donnell, just as a navigator continuously takes reading to ensure whether he is relative to a planned action, so should a business manager continually take reading to assure himself that his enterprise is on right course. Okay, again, management is what? To have a control. If there is no controlling, then the resources may be wasted. Okay, no one have a control over the work, there may be financial losses. So what exactly controlling is just a business manager continually take reading to assure himself that the enterprising is in right course, means the things are taking place in right manner. Okay, so controlling has got two basic purposes. Now what are those purposes? It facilitates coordination, it helps in planning. Okay, everywhere when and the controlling is maximum done at the last stage. Okay, something has been told by the manager, then it is up to the employees to perform that particular task or the activity, and then again the actual performance has been judged by the manager whether the things are done as per the set plans, that is controlling in the language of management. Now, features of controlling. Controlling is an end function. What is that controlling? It is a function. A function which comes once the performance are made in conformity with plan. Means it is checking with what is said and what is achieved. Correct. What was said? Target was said that every month there must be 10 lakh copy. Now it is up to the marketing manager. He will see whether all the marketing members, all the team or sales team, whether they have achieved 10 lakhs of target every month. That is what is controlling. So it comes once the performance are made in conformity with plan. So what was planned? 10 lakh was planned, and what is actually achieved? Maybe there is a 8 lakh or 9 lakh. So again, it is up to the manager to work over that, what is left or how it can be improved. So controlling is a pervasive function. What kind of function it is? It is a pervasive. It means it is performed by manager at all levels and in all type of concerns. Okay. It is not that only top management will perform that function, but all levels of the management, each and every employee who is working in that specific management, in that business, it is performed by each of them. So, controlling is forward looking, because effective control is not possible without past being controlled. So, controlling always looks to future so that follow can be made whenever required. Correct? Just now I have told example of 10 lakhs. The set target was to achieve the profit of 10 lakhs, monthly 10 lakhs. But for how much actually earned? Only 8 lakhs is earned. Now, again, forward looking. Now, it is the task, or it is the, what you say, the skill of the marketing manager. Now, what kind of efforts he will take that the remaining 2 lakhs will be covered in the next month profit? What extra efforts the team should take for the sake of management? That is why it is called forward looking. Okay, means every time controlling must be there. Okay, he has to manage, or he has to arrange some training for the team members. He has to take some extra efforts. He has to give them some facilities if something is not taking place as per the requirement of the employees. Then in that case, it is the job of the manager to help them throughout. It is not because you have not achieved that 10 lakh target, then you will be fired or you will be removed from the job. But necessary steps should be taken by the manager to improve whatever the lacunas are in the process of management. So, in the process of controlling. Now, controlling is a dynamic process. Since controlling requires taking reviewable methods, changes have to be made wherever possible. Dynamic means what? Whatever is the current fashion, whatever is the recent requirement. So, the managers, rather all the employees, should cope up themselves with this dynamism. So, controlling is a dynamic process. Now, controlling is related with planning. Planning and controlling are two inseparable functions. What is said? Inseparable means it cannot be separated. Planning cannot be separated from controlling. Controlling cannot be separated from planning. These are two inseparable functions of the management. Without planning, controlling is a meaningless exercise, and without controlling, planning is useless. So, planning presupposes controlling, and controlling succeeds planning. Okay, means to control, you must plan. And if there is no plan, there should not be proper controlling. So, it goes hand to hand. So, planning and controlling are two inseparable functions. Now, importance of control. Now, why controlling is important? What is the importance of the controlling? It guides the management in achieving predetermined goals. It helps. Okay. We can also say it guides or it helps the management in achieving predetermined goals. The continuous flow of information about projects keeps the long range of planning on the right track. It helps in taking corrective actions in future if the performance is not up to the mark. I think this pain-like example is sufficient to understand you what is controlling. Rather, you can take the help of that example. Now, how the controlling is important? Because it guides the management. Every time managers, okay, the superiors, the employers are there behind the team members, behind the subordinates, behind the people working in the organization, so as the process of controlling should be controlled. At the same time, the process of controlling which is continuous, so that there should not be any problem in handling with the employees, or proper attention must be given to the team members, to the persons, to the employees, to the subordinates of the organization. So, guides the management in achieving predetermined goals. Ensure effective use of scarce and valuable resources. The very important resource from the management point of view is finance. Okay, and always resources are scarce. Okay, at the same time valuable. But if those resources are used in effective manner, so it ensures effective use of scarce and valuable resources. Who ensures? Controlling ensures effective use of scarce and valuable resources. The control system helps in improving organizational efficiency. Various control devices act as motivators to the managers. The performance of every person is regularly monitored, and any deficiency if present is corrected at the earliest. So, controls put psychological pressure on persons in the organization. On the other hand, control also enables management to decide whether employees are doing right things. Okay, ultimately what is that? Here, if there is a proper coordination, if there is a proper cooperation among the employers and employees, then definitely controlling will be easy. So, it happens that employees feel the work pressure. They feel that they are getting, what you say, overburdened of the work, because control puts psychological pressure. Because when there is a huge work, a single employee has to perform 10 to 12 activities in a day. It means what? He is overburdened. He has a workload. But control puts psychological pressure on the persons in the organization. But on the other hand, controlling also enables management to decide whether employees are doing right things. See, every employee, every manager, he is better known about the qualities and capacity of the employee who are working in the organization. That they know, such and such employee, he can better perform. Although he is overloaded with the work, but he is so efficient and he has that capacity to carry on the work. So, it happens. Although it gives a psychological pressure on him or her, but they know only this is the person who can do well in the work, who can give the results. So, on the other hand, that is why it is said, on the other hand, control also enables management to decide whether employees are doing the right things. Sometimes happens exploitation of the workers, exploitation of the employees may be possible in case of controlling, because controlling means what? Ruling. They are ruling over their team members, over their employees. So many of the times they are harsh. They want the work within a stipulated time. As they say, I want the particular work to be done within 1 hour, it means the employee has to give the performance. He has to show that work will take place within 1 hour, means 1 hour. So that psychological pressure demoralizes the employees many times. But if the resources, the resources which are scarce, and if it is utilized in a proper manner, then it is definitely helpful from the management point of view. Correct? So, effective ensures effective use of scarce and valuable resources. Then facilitates coordination. Control helps in coordination of activity through unity of action. Every manager will try to coordinate the activities of his subordinates in order to achieve departmental goals. Similarly, the chief executive also coordinates the functioning of various departments. The control acts as a check on performance, and proper results are achieved only when activities are coordinated. See, whenever we are talking about all the topics like coordination, okay, cooperation, delegation of authority, centralization, decentralization, all these terms are referred or used with reference to the
multinational work business or with reference to the corporate business. Because if the business is large, if the activities are taking place at a larger scale, then only such things are required. Then there will be different departments when the organization is big. When there will be purchase department, when there will be sales departments, where there will be marketing department, when the particular business is manufacturing business. Okay, manufacturing means what? You are creating the goods. Okay, the goods are produced for the sake of the society. Now when the goods are produced, then only in that organization sales department is there, purchase department is there, production department is there, because goods are produced. Because produced goods are sold, so there is a sales department. Because they want to produce the goods, they want to create the utilities, for that sake purchase department is there, because there is a requirement of raw material, and that is why purchase department is there. So every time you need to remember that whatever the points we are discussing here, then let it be the delegation of authority, let it be a coordination, centralization, decentralization, then in that case you have to remember that these things are mainly talked in the corporate or in the multinational business or in the big companies like Tata, Birla and Ambani. Correct? So why I am giving you these examples? Because it is easy for you to understand. Because what here it is said, the chief executive also coordinates the functioning of various departments. Now what are these various departments? Okay, sales department, purchase departments, accounts department, then production department. These are the different departments. And when there will be different departments, if the organization is big or the big enterprise is the, means the big enterprise is there. So you need to remember that. Now leads to delegation and decentralization of authority. A decision about follow-up action is also facilitated. Control makes delegation easier and better. Decentralization of authority is necessary in big enterprises. Dekho, just now I have discussed and the words are here. Decentralization of authority is necessary in big enterprises. The management cannot delegate authority without ensuring proper control. When the authority is delegated, again here you have to remember, delegation of authority is very important topic. The decentralization of authority is necessary in big enterprises. But authority in what sense? Authority, accountability and responsibility, that goes together. So the management cannot delegate authority without ensuring proper control. Here specifically it is talked about the finance. If the supervisor, he has given the authority to spend money up to 5,000, but if there is no control upon that rupees 5,000, then the subordinate or the supervisor, okay, who is at a middle level, and generally the rights or the responsibilities are not given to these level of persons, but considering the nature of the work and considering the demand of the work, he has given the authority. But there should be a check, there should be a control on authority. So the targets or the goals of various departments are used as a control technique. Various control techniques like budgeting, cost control, pre-action approval, etc. allow decentralization without losing control over activities. Clear? I hope the things are clear. Spare stop management to concentrate on policy making. For control processes, management's attention is not required every now and then. The management by exceptions enables top management to concentrate on policy formulation. See, every company, every organization adopts its different, its own policies or different policies. It is not necessary that the company like Tata will have the same policies in Birla company, okay, or in Ambuja Cement company. Every organization have a different set of policies, and they are working according to their own policies. But top management to concentrate on policy formulation. Every time the controlling is in the hand of top management. That you need to remember. So we will stop here. I hope the topic or the discussion in today's class is clear for you. Thank you.